we're going to focus on a lesson dealing with money. Who likes money? I like money. I know you guys do. So what we're going to do is we're going to kind of look more in depth at a dollar bill. Okay? On a dollar bill, you guys mostly just use to buy gum or toys or whatever you guys enjoy. You kind of just hand it to the cashier, get your change, get your toy, and kind of leave. Do you ever look closer at a dollar bill? Probably not. No. So what we're going to focus on is those fine details. You each have a magnifying glass, a sheet of paper, and a dollar bill in front of you. I want you guys to spend about 4 or 5 minutes just kind of looking for any details that catch your eye. You know, anything that you find different or you think has significance on the front and the back. Go ahead and make a list. You can talk amongst yourselves. Anything you find interesting that you want to know more about. Okay? I'm going to walk around, help you guys out, answer any questions.
You want us to write our questions?
Yep, you can write it. Do you like short keywords or anything that comes to mind? Whatever's easier for you, you can write a whole phrase if you'd like. You guys to pause for a second. I want you to grab a dry erase marker. Can anyone tell me what the name of the president is on your dollar bill? And you just go ahead and write it on your desk for me. I want you guys to stop where you're at, finish your thought that you have on your paper. And what you're going to do is I want you to share with your table. You know, you guys can each take one or two things that you found and share it with your table and see if maybe someone else knows what that is. Or you guys can work together and try and just come up with an idea of what it means or what it is on the bill. So each of you kind of pick out one or two of your thoughts, and kind of share with your group, and we'll come together. and share it together. Unless there's a lot of leaves. I'm not sure what kind of leaves, but there's a lot of leaves in that. The flag he has, the stars are not on the flag, they're above his head. All right, so you guys have some time to share. I've heard some really good ones, really good things that I didn't notice, like the eagle, how Elizabeth said the eagle had the stars above it, not on the flag. It's a good thing to look into. Can anyone tell me, or better yet, we'll write it on our table. Can you tell me what the phrase on the top of the back of the bill is? What that phrase is? Very good. Good job. In God we trust. Go ahead and erase it. So I'm going to bring up the dollar bill on here. On our board. And we're kind of going to go through together and label different things. Okay. So, we're going to start with the easiest one. President, which is name on the bill. Can anyone either come up and point it out or circle it for me? Mm-hmm. Sure. Picture's not that great, but yes. Very good. So the president's name is underneath the president. That wasn't added till later on, whenever they produced the bills. They did it to give significance to the president and make sure everyone knew that's Washington. You know, give them credit where credit's due. Let's see here. Does anyone know what this is? I know it's blurry, but on your bill, do we have any idea what it could be?
What's that? The Treasurer of the United States.
Very good. It's their signature. So the treasurer's signature is over here. Do you guys know who the adjacent one is? There's one directly across. I don't expect you to know this, but just in case you have a wild idea.
The secretary of the treasury?
Very good. Secretary of the treasury. One, the one on your right-hand side?
Yeah.
Your your right hand side is going to be your obverse, I believe. Yes, your obverse one, and your left is your inverse. So they're called the Great Seal. Super small on yours. Oh, do we know what that is? The year of Franklin. Very good. So it's the plate. It's the series date. Research them and kind of just write all together at the end a paragraph talking about those five things and what exactly they are on the bill. Okay? This is going to be our research project. All did wonderful research projects. Now that we know, we have a very good understanding of the front of the dollar bill and back. So, to summarize our entire lesson, we not only just hand this to a cashier, we know the significance of the letter or the numbers or why we can see things through a bill. Okay? All these different things make the dollar bill legal, you know. There are people who make it counterfeit, try and sell it or use it, but our treasury has a significant way of making it to where everything has its purpose, whether we think of it or not. You know, the president being on our bill, the name, the inverse and obverse seals on the back, the sayings in God we trust. And then we have the Latin on the back as well. Everything has a purpose. So next time you guys go to pay for something or you get a new dollar bill, whenever they print new ones, I know they recently did the new $100 bills, or you even get like a $2 bill. Everyone is different. They're all different, but they may have similar qualities. Like they will all have their serial number and their series date and their numbers in the corners. I know with the $100 bill, they have that cool bar in the middle, which makes it even more difficult to duplicate, you know, different things. You should be able to see the president like a hologram almost with a bill if you look into the sun. So anyone, let's do this. Can everyone tell me one thing they learned in this lesson? Just one. Simple, whether it can be silly, it was something you really thought was cool, whichever we can go, raise hands, or I can just pick.
I didn't realize that Washington's name or that the president's names were actually listed on there.
Very good. Very good. different. That and looking at them too, you know.
Yeah, I never looked close to that one.
Mm-hmm. And how Alyssa said earlier, one of her things that she mentioned was the leaves that we have all over the bill. I didn't pay attention to the fact that there were leaves on the bill one time. You know, it's just kind of decoration that you don't look into it too much. And I also heard that there are pink and black.
Pink and blue.
Pink and blue specks.
Little fibers. Yeah.
Into the bill, which I think is pretty cool. You know, you don't look that close, but you know, you get close up and you can see things you never thought of before. Alyssa, did you have something you learned?
Oh, about serial numbers.
Very cool.
Letters and numbers are serial numbers.
Yep. They have serial numbers. Each bill is unique. They each have, you know, the date, their own number, and then whenever they get old, they retire, and they bring out new ones. So, you guys did great today. We're going to collect our materials.